Another skincare buzzword making waves? NAD+. Some call it a miracle for reversing aging, but what's hype, what's hope, and what's actually backed by science? Let's take a closer look at what NAD+ does for your skin. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Anne, a medical doctor here to teach you how to best take care of your skin and general well-being. NAD+ is short for nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide and is a non-protein compound acting as coenzyme in many different cells in the body. Coenzymes are necessary for the proper function of different enzymes, but not enzymes themselves. They are a third factor that needs to be present for a reaction to happen. Enzyme substrate or coenzyme. Think of it like the key when starting the car. You need the car, you need the fuel, but even if you have these two, you'll still need the key to start the engine and get the process running. The processes NAD+ acts as coenzyme in mainly evolve around DNA repair and energy production in the cells, and it is found in many different tissues in the body. It isn't exclusive to the skin. Like many other good things, though, it declines as we age. Not in all tissues equally, but still enough throughout the body to make a difference. The decline is due to an increasing imbalance between NAD production and consumption. As the need for repair processes increases, the older we are, the more damage there is to tend to, it seems. And at the same time, the nicotinamide phosphoribosyl transferase, NAMPT, it is the enzyme responsible for recycling used up NAD+, declines. So in short, NAD gets used up quicker and at the same time isn't recycled as efficiently as it used to. We have known about the importance of NAD+ for a long time, as there is a specific disease called pellagra caused by NAD+ deficiency that presents with dermatitis, diarrhea, dementia, and finally death if untreated, and that has basically been eliminated by fortifying food with B vitamins. It is like scurvy, but based on a different vitamin deficiency. The role of NAD+ in the skin is basically the same as everywhere else in the body. It repairs DNA damage and makes sure there is enough energy present in the cells for them to do what they are supposed to do. A main source of DNA damage in the skin is, for example, UV exposure, which NAD+ helps repair, but no, you shouldn't use it instead of sunscreen. I just know that someone somewhere might come to that conclusion. So, with declining levels of NAD+ in the skin cells, existing damage in the skin doesn't get repaired as quickly as it once did, and the different cells lack the energy to produce, for example, collagen and elastin. And we all know what that means in terms of appearance. Wrinkles start to show and skin starts to sag. Some TikTok users call NAD+ a miracle molecule that will reverse skin aging, which raises three red flags for me. Miracle, reverse, and social media hype. When talking about NAD+ for skin aging, we need to distinguish two different things: topical application through skincare products and oral or intravenous supplementation. Let's look at topical first. When you look at the brands promoting products around NAD+ levels, they often use claims like reduce fine lines, enhance elasticity, restore a youthful appearance, which are vague enough to still count as skincare claims, and promote their product as regenerative or skincare on a cellular level, which promotes the impression that the products work not only superficial, but on a deeper cellular level. And I get that. When NAD levels decline, we apply NAD where we want it to increase, on the skin, and watch our replenished cells wake up and get going. Sounds convincing. The common problem in topical products, though, is how do we get it into the cells, and if it gets into the cells, will it actually have the effect we hope it has? NAD+ is a large molecule and charged, meaning it doesn't really penetrate the skin very well. It is also unstable, so it is likely to degrade quickly, either in the product or directly after application. This is why most brands don't use NAD+ for application, but precursors, so ingredients that are converted into NAD+ in the cells. One that you have surely heard of is a prominent vitamin B in skincare, niacinamide. In my video on the benefits of niacinamide in your skincare, I mentioned that part of its effect is due to an increase in NAD+ levels in the skin. There are newer precursors called nicotinamide riboside, NR, and nicotinamide mononucleate, NMN, that are closer to NAD+ than niacinamide, so could in theory trigger a higher boost of the NAD+ in the cells, but both are again unstable in watery solutions and bigger than niacinamide, so that theoretical boost effect could be counteracted by worse penetration. They are, however, what is often included in NAD+ promoting products. Niacinamide isn't really something you can justify a higher price point with. While we have studies looking at topical application of NAD+ and its precursors, there aren't many, and they don't really answer the questions you might have. There is a 2024 in vitro study where NHD Plus was applied to fibroblasts that showed that UV protection was increased by this topical application, and that adding enzymes that might inhibit the enzymes breaking down NHD Plus in the cell increases the effect even further. Very interesting, but as they were working on isolated fibroblasts, it doesn't tell us if and how NHD Plus would actually get into the skin. For a topical NHD precursor application, nicotinamide mononucleate, in that case, we have animal studies that show improvement in eczema lesions and increased protection of the skin against UV damage in mice, which seems to show that NMN is able to penetrate the skin with beneficial effects, at least in mice with a compromised skin barrier. We also have a human study from 2007 where the NHD Plus containing ointment was used in psoriasis patients and compared to placebo, same vehicle but without the NHD Plus, on matched psoriatic lesions. Here the NHD Plus ointment performed better than placebo and comparable to antraline and established therapy. It was also possible to keep the NHD Plus stable, fresh batches and kept refrigerated, and patients found it to be cosmetically pleasing in texture. This answers some questions regarding topical penetration on an impaired barrier, formulation and beneficial effects, but can't be transferred to skin aging and cosmetic products that aren't produced fresh and kept refrigerated. These aren't all studies available, but all studies have one thing in common. There are either animal studies, in vitro studies, which means studies conducted outside living organisms, typically in a lab dish, or done in a very small population with specific characteristics, meaning they offer great insights but aren't proof. They show that topical application is generally considered safe though, which is a good start. But you know where we have a lot of studies? Niacinamide, not directly on its effect on NHD Plus level in the cells, but on how it improves signs of aging in a split phase trial, for example, indirectly supporting the claim that NHD Plus levels are important. Now, what about using NHD Plus or its precursors orally? Straight NHD Plus as supplement will have no effect at all, as it is broken down by digestion. You will have to stick to the precursors. There are nicotinamide riboside and previously also nicotinamide mononucleotide pills available that will, that match has been demonstrated, increase NHD Plus levels in human tissue. The increase they provided wasn't, however, reproducible in all tissues and in all studies, with the effects varying depending on dosage and treatment duration as well as study population, male-only versus mixed genders, age group studies, and overall healthy versus patients with pre-existing conditions like obesity, neurodegenerative disease, and cardiovascular disease, meaning there's a lot we don't know yet. The main one being if this increase in NHD Plus levels does translate to general health or skin improvements. That remains unclear, mostly because the studies done focus on lifestyle improvement rather than skin, and things like more energy are quite hard to objectively measure. Some more objective indicators like systolic blood pressure or level of circulating cytokines have shown promising trends in small sample sizes. There don't seem to be any side effects other than costing you money, so it might be worth a try for you. I personally don't really take supplements. NMN, however, can no longer be sold as dietary supplement in the US due to the FDA reclassifying it as investigational drug, meaning is now treated as a substance under investigation or formally under investigation for potential therapeutic uses rather than a general supplement, so for now only niacin and nicotinamide riboside are available. In general, the topical application of both NHD Plus and its precursors seem to be safe and widely tolerated, and the same seems to be true for oral supplementation. NHD Plus infusions, on the other hand, seem to come with discomfort, with people reporting nausea, chest tightness, and headaches, probably because NHD Plus in high concentrations in the bloodstream isn't physiological, meaning the body isn't used to it. The increase with oral precursors happens slower and is closer to how it usually works. IVs are also quite expensive, and just like anything else that punctures the skin, associated with the potential risk for infection, even though that should be small when the provider follows hygienic precautions. Topicals NHD Plus isn't something I'd invest in. I will stick to my niacinamide in the products I already use, pay a fraction of the price, and will most likely have the same benefits. And as I bet niacinamide is already present in your routine as well, you can keep using whatever worked for you in the past with a good feeling that you are absolutely up to speed with this new trend. And if you enjoyed this video, you will most likely enjoy the ones linked on the screen here. Don't forget to check out the description box for everything else I have to offer, and like and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss the next video.